Swan's coming. It's one of those beautiful, crisp autumn mornings today, and there's few places I'd rather be than this location close to home. This is such a fantastic habitat. You've got a mixture of open water and water channels snaking through the reed bed. And at this time of year as well, just starting to get a little bit of colour change. Not too much, but just a little bit. It's just colouring some of the reeds and some of the bushes as well. This location can also be fantastic for early morning mists. So particularly in the spring and the autumn, when you get the right conditions, warmer the day before, then the temperature dropping overnight, you've got a really good chance of mists here, just hanging above the water. And it's also in kind of a bit of a dip as well, so that helps for the mist to form. As we get into August and September, we just get so much more movement here on the reserve. Lots of birds coming and going, more flocks, particularly geese flocks, some waders and ducks as well, and makes it great for photography. And I'm particularly after the geese and the geese in the mist, if you've seen the last video. As well as a lot of the common species, we also get the gadwall, which I really like the gadwall. I think it's one of my favourite ducks. And they do this kind of very strange flight. It's almost like the, I don't know, it's just a group of them. They just kind of fly around in circles. They're twisting and turning, calling all the time. They're really quite loud. It's almost like a bit of a display flight, I don't know if it is, but I've seen them doing this quite a few times and managed to photograph it in the autumn. Swan's coming. I couldn't figure out which way to turn the camera because that was because it's like backwards. Yeah, anyway, what was I? Also get some fantastic lapwing flocks here, and if you wait long enough, there's a good chance that the lapwing are just going to shoot up all as one mass, a great big black and white fluttering mass. Maybe a predator spooked them. Sometimes they just seem to do it for no reason. That's been a great photo opportunity here as well, particularly when I've got the right light. So in terms of my technique for these kind of images early in the morning where there's potential mist around, I always use automatic ISO, let the camera look after the ISO, and then I just add a bit of overexposure, maybe around plus one. That gets good results for me. I also, on my camera, I limit the ISO to a maximum of 3200, and I importantly set a minimum shutter speed because I'm using aperture priority. So I set a minimum shutter speed of either 500th or 1000, depending on how I feel. Despite my difficulty of getting up in the morning ever since I was a kid, morning is still my favourite time. The reason being that you're just going to get more atmospheric shots that just aren't possible. You can't get frost and mist in the evening, not really. So morning is definitely preferable for me. But the evening here can be fantastic if you've got good light. Still got birds flying around and coming into roost, bit of movement towards the end of the day as the sun goes down. One of the things you should check as well is your wind direction. So be aware of the wind direction when particularly you're shooting flight shots, because birds will tend to land into the wind and take off into the wind as well. So just try and be aware of where the wind is coming from, particularly if it's relatively strong. We can get some wonderful sunsets here, and that's largely because there's not really anything to block out the light. So you can get the sunlight all through the day, from first thing in the morning to last thing in the evening, every last drop. And as the sun gets lower in the sky, I really enjoy shooting backlit, looking towards the sun as it gets lower and lower. And once the sun drops below that horizon and the colour starts to form in the sky, then I'll be looking again for any birds in flight, flocks, those geese flocks again. If you're a regular viewer, you might have noticed this video is a little bit different, so please do drop me a comment in the comments box, just let me know what you think. I've been trying to do more wildlife filming and more b-roll, just to mix it up a bit, and in the future I'm hoping to do more pure wildlife, just wildlife filming, more documentary style as well, with a bit less of me in there. So let me know what you think, whether you think that's good or bad. If you're not a subscriber, then I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope it makes you want to subscribe, and I'll see you somewhere in nature sometime soon.